Hello. Hello again. I'm back in Norway, back in Oslo. This is my hometown. Behind me you can see the parliament, and if we move a bit around you can see the buildings, and way up behind me there would be the King's Castle. So the summer is coming here in Oslo. At least it's warmer than in the past few months, because just 1 month ago or so there was snow around. And now it's better, but it's never going to be as warm as it was in Somaliland when I left there. Because then in Somaliland it's like plus 30 a lot, but here it's very seldom more than 30 degrees centigrade. Now this experience I had in Somaliland was quite amazing. I mean, it's a crazy adventure for me, just to be able to go to a country like that, which is not even recognized as a country, and then have this warm welcome with all the people showing their open hands and open heart. It's just amazing for me. I will talk about Somaliland on my speeches on stage, in my conferences, and to people that I meet, because it deserves to be promoted. Now, I was warned when I started this video blogging that there will be, negative haters, people that don't want Somaliland to be recognized as its own country. There will be Somalis coming on to spew hatred and negative comments on my videos, etc. But luckily, it's been 95% at least positive comments, very, very nice and warm comments, which goes to show that the Somaliland people are warm and nice and very friendly and empathetic. But there was maybe like 5% hateful messages, and really like, oh, you are promoting Somaliland leaving Somalia, and all of this is horrible and whatever. I'm not interested in politics, but I am curious why Somalia as a nation would not let Somaliland just leave. I mean, it's a barren country, doesn't have much resources, it's the very poor part of this area, and Somalia has two big rivers and much more resources and everything. So I wonder why they don't say, okay, please just leave. I asked people on my videos if they can just provide some logical reasons why Somaliland should not be recognized as its own country. Not emotional or historical or all kinds of, non-logical reasons. I would like to see some logical explanations why it should stay a part of Somalia. I mean, it's been a de facto republic, a well-functioning democracy for almost 30 years. So it seems to be able to stand on its own legs without much interference, or even without foreign aids in comparison to the neighboring nations. So, and I also wonder if it gets recognition, maybe that will destroy the country, because now it's been able to build itself from scratch with nothing. If it's been given a lot, maybe foreign aid, maybe that will kill that build from scratch attitude. Maybe, I don't know. Now, I do highly applaud the attitude of the Somaliland people having brought to life a country from scratch, a functioning democracy with a secure, peaceful place where they can prosper, which is an amazing feat, given that so many of the countries around it has been given enormous amount of foreign aid and still fails to build the same as Somaliland did from scratch, from a war zone. So it's an amazing situation. Now, I did, back in 2009, try to go to Somalia to do the same project that I'm proposing for Somaliland now. But, as I said in my first video, it failed because my wife wouldn't let me go, because it was starting to become a war in Mogadishu, so I couldn't go. So I did try, actually, to promote this idea in Somalia first. I don't have anything against any of the countries. I would like to help Somalia, I would like to help Somaliland, I would like to help anybody. But now this turned out to be the opportunity that was most possible to go with Fatima to Somaliland, and I would like to see Somaliland prosper as its nation, and with the people and with the attitude of building things from scratch. I think is very interesting. I would also like to help Somalia. I would also like to help Djibouti or Eritrea or Ethiopia or anybody else that makes it possible to receive help. Because I'm not a political individual, I'm not a religious individual. I don't meddle in politics or religious affairs at all. I would like to help the people, but I would like to help the people as the people they are, with the attitude they have. So if we can just refrain from all the hatred and the spewing of shit and crap like some of the comments have been on my video, it would be helpful. I mean, just helping other people is a nice thing to do. So I also applaud everybody that wants to join in on this project and to help as teachers. And also I got a lot of comments from people on my videos and also back channel on Messenger and email, etc., on those who would like to join as students in the project. So we have a lot of different angles, and people want to help, people want to participate. It's a very nice reception this whole project idea has gotten. So now it is for me to create by the 1st of May a real memorial understanding with the government of Somaliland, also proposing a plan on how to actually do the project, how to secure the funding, how to secure the teachers, how to actually get it all up and running, starting. I'm aiming for the end of this year. I don't know if that's realistic, we'll see, but that's the aim at least. So thanks again for all the support. Thanks again for everybody that has communicated with me. Now I'm going to turn around a little bit just to show you my Oslo, the capital. This is downtown. It's a city which is smaller than Hargeisa and a lot colder, especially in the winter. But I like the cold. I don't take heat too easily. So this is the parliament, as you can see. Now, signing off for now. I might do more videos on my reflections as the week goes by, but do not count on getting a video every day now, because now I'm back home. Four kids, lots of work to do. You know, I got my consultancy business to run and the coaching of athletes and artists and all of these other things I'm doing in my daily life here back in Oslo. So be patient with the videos. Now, if you want to track my other progress, because I have a lot of other things I do in life. I create music, as you know. I write one-page books. I do photography. I create 3D digital artwork. I do a lot of blog posting. I do some podcasting, although the videos have gotten a lot more traction than my podcasts. It might be that I'm doing more videos in the future because podcasting seems to get a lot less attention. Not that I'm very seeking attention, but it would be interesting for people to read and listen to my stuff and give feedback to me, because the reason why I'm doing this is because I want to learn. And then traction and comments and feedbacks is very welcome, because that helps me learn things. So if you want to keep, keep informed in what I do, also on the programming side, I do a lot of programming. I have 50 plus repositories on GitHub, but I also do a lot of HP calculator programming, which is some of my great interests, and also astronomy, and getting a new telescope soon. Will also, I will shoot some pictures through my telescope. I will do some interesting stuff on astronomy, I guess, and also particle physics and mathematics and all those things. So if you want to keep track of the nerdiness of me, what you should do is go to the bottom of the page of isene.org, isene.org, and you can subscribe to my webpage, and you will get emails every time I publish something new. So there you have it. Let's keep in touch, and bye for now.